shifting from a mindset of lack to a mindset of abundance. Have you ever felt that you have to go after what you want in fear that you're gonna miss out? Do you have thoughts of missing out on something, what some call FOMO, fear of missing out? Do you have the feelings of being anxious because you can't do something or buy something or experience something right now? Or do you feel that no matter what you have, it's never enough? Even when you have money, you feel it's still not enough. And there's a fear that in the future, you're gonna run out. All of these feel bad. When we view life from the perspective of lack, we are primarily aware of what's wrong, what's missing, or what's manifesting in a way that's more less than or different than we would like it to be. Lack always feels bad. Someone with a mindset of lack and limitation simply does not have access to the same range of opportunities that someone that's in a mindset of abundance. So let me say that again, because this is big. Someone with a mindset of lack and limitation does not have access to the same range of opportunities that someone who is in a mindset of abundance does. And it's not because these opportunities exist for one and not the other. They exist in the field of pure potentiality for all of us. But we have to be receptive to them. And when we are in lack, we close off, we close down to all the magic, miracles, and potential. The solutions to our problems and the answers to our burning questions are available to us, each one of us, equally. But this is a universal law that what we focus on expands. If we're focused on lack and limitation, we will find a never-ending stream of evidence to support our lack perspective. And did I mention lack feels bad? The same goes when we're grounded in possibility thinking. When our mindset is one of openness, trust, and positive expectation, we rendezvous with opportunities that we just can't access when we're mired in doubt or despair. Abundance feels good because it's in alignment with the divine. In making the shift from lack-based thinking to one of possibility or abundance-based thinking is one of the most immediate and powerful ways to come into energetic alignment with any outcome that you desire to create. I want to share a story. One year when I was touring and I was doing different talks, I was talking on the law of attractions about 15 years ago, and I happened to be in LA, and I had just done a workshop the night before, and I had a woman that came in with a chip on her shoulder. They had 20 people in the room that were so excited to learn about law of attraction. And everything I said, everything I was teaching, she scoffed at, she shrugged at. And I literally stopped in the middle and I said, you know, if this isn't resonating with you, you're welcome to leave and you can get your money back. And she goes, no, I'm staying here. As if resigned to just hackle, you know, hassle me, right? Like a comedian being heckled, I guess, in the audience. And so I just kind of let myself stop focusing on her and focusing on all the people that were eager to learn more. Well, the next day I'm at the airport in LA, big airport, LAX. And I'm kind of sunken down and I'm thinking about this woman and how I let her get to me and all the things. I just felt so much in lack that I just didn't show up enough. I didn't do enough. I wasn't able to shift her. And I was focused on really beating myself up quite a bit. And finally I went, stop, enough. And I shifted my stance. I allowed myself to feel good about the other 19 people that were shifted and came up to me and were so grateful. I focused on them and how their lives are gonna change as a result of being there. And as soon as I changed my stance, all of a sudden a man walked in front of me. And I thought, that looks like Wayne Dyer, who was one of my earliest teachers. And I noticed there was a sign that said Maui, and he had a house in Maui. So I thought, oh. So here I am in the middle of LAX, a place that many people probably know Wayne Dyer. And I walked up to him and I said, Dr. Wayne Dyer, he turned to me I was like, oh, what is your name? And we had the most lovely connection, gave me a huge hug. We were talking, he said, what are you doing here? It was so, they say you shouldn't meet your heroes. In this case, I was so glad I did because he was more than what I even anticipated he would be like. Someone else came up to him and said, oh, are you Wayne Dyer? You know, my mom's been listening to you and reading your books for years. And he was so gracious. He said, well, you've got to know Christy Whitman. And she kind of like went, no, you know, but he included me in the conversation. What a wonderful man. All of this to say, had I been in my pity party, had I stayed stuck in the lack of what I did and how I showed up and continued to hunch down, I would have missed that opportunity that Wayne Dyer walked in front of me and opened up to possibilities, opened up to alignment, to be able to have one of the most connection and unforgettable times of my life. So to make this shift, like I did, simply ask yourself three questions. Number one, what do I desire to create from this situation? In this situation, how do I believe, number two, how do I believe the fulfillment of this desire will cause me to feel? For me, it was, I want people to feel good. I want people to feel expanded. I want people to feel open. I want their lives to change. And when I started focusing on that, it was like, oh, 19 of them did, right? Number three, what can I do right now to generate and nurture this feeling within myself? By looking beyond what you want to the deeper desire of why you want it, you reconnect with the bottom line feeling that you're truly longing to experience. And you discover that this feeling is available to you right now. Your happiness, your vitality, your clarity, your sense of empowerment, your sense of freedom is not dependent on the behavior of another person. These are all vibrational states of being that you have the ability to cause for yourself now, in this moment, by choosing. We don't need to postpone it until we arrive at some future destination. So, in any area of your life that you're not feeling satisfied, ask yourself those questions. What do I desire to create in this situation? Number two, how do I believe this fulfillment of this desire will cause me to feel? And what can I do? Number three, what can I do right now to generate and nurture this feeling within myself? Remember, you are here to thrive and to feel good. Desires are life-giving, and they are important for your expansion into joy. Pick up your copy of The Desire Factor today.